Today we're having a look at the advanced plasma accelerators and whether they're actually worth getting, and if they are, they're good for. Hello ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Elite Dangerous with Down to Earth Astronomy. Let's have a look at some of the advanced plasma accelerators. Now, if you don't know what they are, they are a special type of plasma accelerators, class 3, so large size, you can get through power plate, just like with the prismatic shields and other special modules that are only available through power plate. If we go here to our galactic powers, the plasma accelerators are offered by this guy from the Empire, Denton here. We can see if we go under the pledge menu, when we reach rank 3 with this guy, we get access to the advanced plasma accelerators. And of course, we need to be pledged for the 4 weeks, so same thing with everything else. And we're going to look at them today. We're going to see what's the point of them. What are they good for? So let's start by looking at some of the hard stats for these weapons. Here I have the statistics, or the stats for both the class 3 fixed plasma accelerator, the advanced plasma accelerator, and the class 4. Just to give you a comparison where it is, because the advanced one is kind of in between, yet it is very different. So let's go with the stats from the top. We can see that the power draw is exactly the same as the other class 3. So fitting wise, they are exactly identical to a normal class 3 plasma accelerator. But when we go down to the damage per second, this is when we begin to see the first small difference here. We can see that the damage output of these are kind of in between what you would get from a class 3 and a class 4. So they are kind of a class 3.5 when it comes to damage wise. But the damage per shot is very, very low. If you look at that, it's only 34 on the advanced, where it is 83 on the normal class 3, and the advanced, the big one, the huge one, is 125. The reason why we get this decent DPS is if we go down and we look at the rate of fire, we can see here that the rate of fire on a normal plasma accelerator, this is a thing that's regardless of the size of it, is 0.3 shots a second. That means it takes just over 3 seconds between each shot. Whereas with an advanced plasma accelerator, it's 0.8. This is very, very, very quick. And just to give you a quick comparison here, in the background here, this is small video running where you can see the comparison of the shot speed, and there's really a huge difference. These are all stock weapons that's been fired here. Nothing has been engineered on these, just so you can get the idea of how quickly they actually do fire. Okay, go back and look a bit more on the stats, dive into it again. So, as we've seen already, it's basically a class 3 plasma accelerator with less damage per shot, but with a higher rate of fire, so you fire more shots. Now, of course, to compensate for this, the ammo clip size has been increased from 5 shots per clip to 20 shots per clip. I'll come back to that, and of course, also maximum ammo amount is also increased, so you go from 100 maximum ammo round up to 300. So, this is all good. So far, it looks like what they've done is just make a faster version. But let's go into even more detail here. First of all, let's look at the distributor draw. As you would expect, because it's a faster firing weapon, the distributor draw is a lot lower. We can see here we go from 13.6 down to 5.5 when we compare the two large versions of that. But, of course, the distributor draw is per shot. And because the shot speed is higher, we need to calculate what the distributor draw is per second. And the distributor draw per second is, for the normal class 3, is 4.08 megawatts a second. For the advanced one, it's 4.4. So from 4.08 to 4.4, that's a little less than 10% increase. And for the huge one, it is 6.3. So again, it's kind of in between. It draws a little bit more distributed power than the class 3 one, but still less than the class 4 one. Okay, let's move on to the thermal load. Again, the statistics here on thermal load is also per shot, so this is also lower. But this is where it begins to become interesting, because if we calculate the distributor, the thermal load, so how much of these, I don't know what, they haven't put any units on this, I'm not sure what the actual unit is, but let's just call it thermals. So, the normal plasma accelerator, class 3 normal plasma accelerator, has a thermal load of 6.54 per second. If you do this thermal load and the given rate of fire, calculate the same thing for the advanced one. We go from 6.5 up to 8.8, which is pretty much the same. I think the huge one is 8.85. So the thermal load is the same, pretty much the same as with the huge ones. So thermal load wise, it's a huge one, but distributed draw, it's a large one. So again, it's kind of an in-between kind of thing. Now, another thing I think that's worth mentioning is if we look at the potential damage per clip between reload. So each magazine, how much potential damage do you have in each magazine? Well, of course, it will be a lot higher in the advanced one because of the large number of rounds. Even though the damage is lower, we are still gonna get more damage per magazine than we do with the huge one. So that's definitely a plus, that we have more potential damage in our magazine before we need to reload. But the drawback, of course, is that the increase, the percentage increase in ammo is a lot bigger than the percentage increase in rate of fire, which means that the time it takes to empty the magazine is also longer. A normal plasma accelerator, whether it's class 3 or class 4, or any of the other classes, I guess, it takes 16.67 seconds, so just over 16 and a half seconds to empty a magazine. Whereas with the advanced one, it takes 25 seconds, so from 16 and a half to 25. So it takes you a lot longer to get that damage out there. Is that worth taking into consideration? And if we're gonna take this and put this into some actual combat, I have some footage here running in the background of me actually using these weapons in real combat. And when testing these out, one thing I realized was that for PvE, at least, I don't think they're that good. And the main reason is that when they're fixed, which is normally not an issue, that's okay, we can work with fixed weapons, but because it takes so long to apply the damage, I mean, the effective DPS is good, but that requires that you can keep the gun on the target at all times. Whereas if you use a normal plasma accelerator, you have a lot of time between each shot to align up, get ready, and then fire, and then you get that huge burst of damage once the plasma ball actually hit the target. But with an advanced one, because the rate of fire is so quick, you need to be able to keep on the target at all times in order to get that effective DPS out. That means that in reality, that's not going to happen, so you're going to miss a lot of your shots, unless you are a very, very good pilot. That means that you're effective damage per second, from my experience at least, is going to be a lot lower than what it is on paper. And you're going to get a lot less effective than you are going to be with a plasma accelerator with a longer rate of fire. So keep that in mind when using these. That's why I don't really like them when it comes to PvE. I can see them being very, very effective in PvP, especially if you're trying to hunt people who are running away from you, because if they're just running in a straight line, you can just zoom after them. And it's going to be very easy to keep them on target. So in PvP situations, they could be pretty fun. And I must say, they are fun to use because of the high rate of fire. And the one showing here in the video actually have a rapid fire modification on just to get them shooting even faster. But when you get into situations like the one here, where you can actually keep them on target, the applied DPS is pretty good. But the difficult part is, again, to keep it on the target. And you will also notice here, if I try to use all my weapons, I have some burst lasers on the ship as well, I will overheat, and I will overheat bad. That is, of course, because, remember, we're drawing the same amount of heat as we are from a huge plasma accelerator, but we only draw a distributor draw as we are from a large one, which means that you're going to be able to keep firing for longer. Normally, you would not overheat as easily if you used a huge one, because you would run out of capacitor, and you would have to let that refill between shots. Whereas with this, because the distributor draw is so low, but the thermals are still high, you're gonna generate a lot of heat. And when playing with these, I would often overheat to... I could easily push it beyond 200% if I'm going all out and just firing all my weapons. So they are very, 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 very heat heavy. And you need a good power plant with some good heat efficiencies if you are using these. So so keep that in mind. So in conclusion, I would say that they are good in very specific situations. The skill cap is very high, so use them in... You can use them in maybe PvP, but I would not recommend them for PvE. I would not recommend them in situations where applied DPS is very, very important, as it is in PvE. But anyway, I hope you liked this video. If you did, give it a like down below and remember to subscribe to the channel. And until next time, I will see you guys in space.